Are you still wondering if you can use QuickBooks Online for your construction business? Welcome back to my channel. For those who don't know me, my name is Elizabeth and I am the owner of Beyond Book Solutions, remote bookkeeping and advisory services. We help contractors save time and money and pay themselves more. Today I'll be talking about some important and helpful features that can be used in QuickBooks Online for contractors and construction businesses. But first, I get asked a lot if QuickBooks Online is a good software for the construction industry. The answer is not as simple as yes or no. In comparison with desktop version, QuickBooks Online is missing several features. Most of those features are connected with the reporting options that desktop has. The features that I'm missing from QuickBooks Online that I found usually being helpful are estimate versus actual report, that's number one. Expenses not assigned to jobs report. Another report that has been very important is job cost detail report. Another feature is that markup column and estimates does not really exist in QuickBooks Online. On the other hand, working with QuickBooks Online for years now, I figured out how to create workarounds for those issues in QuickBooks Online with the right setup. QuickBooks Online is an easier software to use, it's more user-friendly. So what are some benefits of using QuickBooks Online? First is that you can have access to it from any device at any time. It's very handy, right? You don't need to head back to the office to fix small issues arising from time to time. Another advantage is that your data is more secure in QuickBooks Online than desktop. You don't need any backups, no stress about losing anything that's important in case your computer crashes. Well, you know how that feels. Automation is also pretty big. In 2022, we need to automate as many things as we can to make our workflow as easy as possible, and QuickBooks Online is on top of it. Besides, when paired with project management software, QuickBooks Online becomes a great tool to make sure your numbers are telling you a story about where you stand in your business and each project. Plus, usually project management software has a lot of helpful features like scheduling, tracking hours of your employees, the communication between customers and your staff. If you want to know more about this, I've made a video on project management software. Just click right here. Now let's get straight to the tips. First up, let's define the projects feature that QuickBooks Online has. It rolled out around 2018. In QuickBooks Online, it is separate from the sub-customers that many people are used to, that has its own reporting features. You can convert sub-customers into projects as well if this is how you started your QuickBooks Online. To have the project feature inside of QuickBooks Online, you will need to subscribe to at least QuickBooks Online Plus, and then you would need to go to the settings and go to advanced and turn on the project feature. After that, you will be able to see it on the left side of your panel in the gray zone. When you click into projects, you are able to create a new project right there. And after you do that, you will be able to track every single expense, bill, invoice, everything in one spot. It provides you a profit and loss statement, the profitability of each project as you click on them. It provides you all the detail and even a profit margin. Another feature that I found extremely useful and I'm using as a workaround. Remember, I just mentioned the feature that's mentioning that the estimates in QuickBooks Online, they don't have a separate column for the markup. Well, the workaround for that is using bundles inside of QuickBooks Online. It is especially very good for lump sum projects when you have to, you know, enter everything as you go. So what you would do first is go into sales, products and services, and you would create all the services that you are using. So let's say it's plumbing. You would create plumbing labor or plumbing subcontractors, and then plumbing materials, and then you would create a separate product that would say markup. You need to make sure that every single service and every single product is assigned to the right sales and distribution categories. After that, you would go in and you would create a bundle, which basically would contain all of those services that you have created. So you will call it just plumbing and include all of those services. So then when you go into estimate and you are creating a new estimate for your customer, you would want to pick those bundles, fill out the amounts for each of the sections, including the markup, and the total would show up in the same estimate. Well, the best part of it is that you can choose if you want to send all of the numbers in detail to your customer, or if your customer just wants to know how much it is for plumbing total, how much it is for electrical total, your drywall total, and they wouldn't be able then to see the details on the invoice that you create out of that estimate. But all the detail is going to be there for you. Another very, very helpful feature is 1099s. You can create 1099s with just a couple clicks of a button inside of QuickBooks Online. But of course, throughout the year, you have to have everything prepped for QuickBooks Online to calculate who needs to receive 1099 and for what amount. Because as you know, the 1099 criteria is very specific. Your contractors, they are earning more than $600 per year and are paid through your checking account. Those people will need to get paid, or probably Zelle as well. I know many contractors are using that. They will need to receive 1099. So every time you're inputting vendor, new vendor into the system, you would need to mark if they're an S corp, if they're just a regular LLC, because you know any corporations are not getting 1099. So after you plug in that information, you plug in the numbers, the address, and you track throughout the year the payments that those people have received. When you go into the section of taxes in your QuickBooks Online and you click on 1099, you will be able to see the list that QuickBooks created of just sole proprietors and LLCs that need to receive the 1099 for the correct amounts accordingly to where you paid it from. And that's pretty much it. For a small fee, QuickBooks will send out all the 1099s and file everything with the government. Another feature that I have mentioned exists in QuickBooks Desktop, but doesn't really in QuickBooks Online, is budget versus actual report. That is my most favorite reports after balance sheet, profit and loss, and statement of cash flow, because it lets you see exactly where you're at with the project during the project and after the project. Especially for those of you who are fixed price projects, who are giving out the estimates and staying true to those numbers, that is definitely the most important report for you, because this is how you know what the actual numbers are compared to what you estimated. Did the cost of materials go up and you didn't realize it? Is productivity of your staff different from what you have estimated? Do you need a higher markup? A lot of questions can be answered if you put in the correct budget, if you actually estimate things correctly, and if you track every single transaction that is supposed to be going against that project, specific project. So unfortunately, QuickBooks Online doesn't really have the budget versus actual reports on its own, but the workaround is that you would be needing to create a lot of accounts that will be named just as your cost codes. Unfortunately, it makes profit and loss very large unless you minimize some of the parent accounts. But after you create those accounts and you connect your products and services to those accounts, you will be able to go ahead and create a budget by clicking settings, budget, and set up the yearly budget. And you will be able to still track the actual expenses inside of projects feature, just like you always do. So then you would be able to go into reports, pull up budget versus actual report, and see where you stand numbers wise. Another very helpful feature could be for contractors is tracking the deposits and prepayments. We all know that if you plug in your deposits into the sales column in your profit and loss statement, it's not exactly true because you haven't earned that money. How can that be hurting your numbers? When you are looking at your profit and loss, let's say on a monthly basis, and your sales are overstated, you can see that your profit is very large, and you're thinking, wow, this is great. I got a large profit percentages. But then you realize that half of that is the deposit that you have received from so many clients, but you haven't really earned them, meaning that there are no expenses to put against those deposits. That's why your profit margin is overstated. So to avoid this, what I recommend doing is creating a receive payment to undeposited funds without any invoice being created. It will save as a credit. And when the service has been performed, you would be creating an invoice and the credit will be applied automatically if you do the right setup in the settings. How to do that? You would go into settings, advanced, and click on automatically apply credits. So then when it is actually earned, that's where you will apply the credits and put it in the right section in the profit and loss statement. Another thing you can easily do in QuickBooks Online is progress invoicing. So what you would do is you would create the estimate, and then on the top right corner, you would be able to click create invoice. It will provide you different options of what kind of invoice you would like to create. If it's gonna be a full amount, half amount, the percentage of it. And then when you send out that invoice and you go back to that estimate, it will be able to show you how much has been estimated, how much has been invoiced, and what the balance is. Another thing you can do is track the retainers and uninvoiced estimate amounts. We have just talked about how to do the progress invoicing and how estimate is actually showing you how much you still haven't invoiced. Well, the last part of the estimate could be the actual retainer. You can see it either if you find the estimate, and you will see inside of estimate, it will show you what the remaining retainer is, and you can invoice it when it's ready to be invoiced. Or you can also go to the report section. The report is called Estimate and Progress Invoicing Summary by Customer. That's where you will be able to see how much is the amount of estimate, how much has been invoiced, and how much is still outstanding. That is it for today. Please let me know in the comments what feature you found the most helpful when dealing with QuickBooks Online for contractors and construction businesses. And don't forget to like this video if you found this information helpful, and subscribe not to miss more of my content. Thank you for watching.